The M5 MacBook Pro is here, and at first glance, it looks very similar to the M4, and most of the features are exactly the same, but Apple did change a couple things with the M5. So in this video, we're gonna go through all the differences between these two machines, and we're also gonna do a lot of real world tests so you can see how much faster the M5 is at some tasks than the M4. Before we get started, I do wanna say thank you to B&H for loaning me this M5 MacBook Pro. They were kind enough to send this over to me so I could run all my tests on it and compare it to some different computers. So we're gonna have lots of different comparisons coming out on the channel. And I've also got the M5 with the upgraded 24 gigabytes of RAM and the 1 terabyte SSD in it coming as well. So we can see how much better that one is than the base model. But in this video, we're putting the base model M5 up against the M4 base model. The main difference between these is actually the chip. So the M4 in the older version and the M5 in the newer version. And what that means practically is they actually raised the memory bandwidth from 120 gigabytes a second to 153 gigabytes a second now on the M5. They've also added neural accelerators to every single one of the GPU cores, which the neural accelerators are really designed to make AI tasks run faster and more efficiently. And we will see that in some of the testing that we've done, but there's still some work to be done with certain software to make these features even faster than ever. Both of these start out with 16 gigabytes of RAM, and the SSDs start at 512 gigabytes. The RAM goes all the way up to 32 gigabytes, and on the M4, you could only go up to a 2 terabyte SSD. With the M5, now you can get a 4 terabyte SSD if you want, which is going to be pretty expensive if you go for that option. As far as performance goes, when I got the M5 running, I didn't necessarily feel like it was running all that faster. For day-to-day single core style use, so whether you're browsing the web, writing emails, or just doing day-to-day tasks, you're really not going to notice any difference with the new M5. They had very close single core, multi-core, and GPU scores on Geekbench, but there was a nice incremental improvement on the M5 over the M4. The first test where I started noticing a difference was running Diffusion B AI image generation, which I just generated a cat working on a laptop and eating nachos. And on the M4, it took 22 seconds, and on the M5, it took 15 and a half seconds. So it was a little bit faster to generate the image on that. Next, I did some LLM tests on both of the machines, and running LM Studio with GPT OSS 20B, I noticed that the time to the first token was much improved on the M5 over the M4, about half the time for it to actually start working. Also, it was generating more tokens a second on the M5 over the M4, which just means it's going to be able to work faster running LLMs on the machine and generate you results faster. I also ran some benchmarks using Geekbench AI, and on the CPU side, the scores were pretty close, but on the GPU side, especially the quantized score, it went through the roof, probably due to the neural accelerators. This just means it's going to be able to handle those AI tasks faster than ever. One test I was pretty surprised with was the disk speed test. On the M4, I was getting 2900 megabytes a second on the read and 2500 on the write. And on the M5, I was getting 6400 megabytes a second on both the read and the write. So over double the SSD speed on the M5 over the M4. This is not the same thing as the memory bandwidth, but this will lead to a lot of performance benefits with moving things around the computer and just day-to-day tasks as well. Several of these next tests were pretty close. Running the Xcode benchmark, I was able to compile the code on the M4 in 3 minutes and 2 seconds. And then on the M5, it was 2 minutes and 48 seconds, so a nice little subtle improvement. And then I also loaded both the Blender classroom scene as well as the Blender barbershop scene and ran them both using the GPU. And I did notice some substantial benefits with the M5 over the M4. Not quite double the speed, but it was significantly faster using the M5 to do rendering in Blender. Next on the list, we've got Logic Pro. My favorite test on Logic Pro is to see how many MIDI tracks you can run with it using a bunch of effects and just playing the same note over and over. And I was able to load 110 channels on the M4 without it dropping. And then on the M5, it was able to go up to 130. So again, just a very small increase in performance on Logic. The next test with Logic were the bounce tests. I have two different tests I run. The first test is loading 600 of that same channel and doing it on an offline bounce and seeing how fast it's able to bounce. On the M4, it took 5 minutes and 15 seconds to bounce. And on the M5, it took 4 minutes and 35 seconds. So a nice little performance boost. And then running a more realistic 64 track bounce, it took 35 seconds on the M4 and 28 seconds on the M5. So if you're using less tracks, you're not gonna feel the difference as much. So you really just get a little bit of buffer using musical apps on the M5 over the M4. The next test was the video exporting test. I created a 3-minute project file with a couple adjustment layers, some titles, some effects, some audio effects. And on the M4, it took 1:49 to export it, and on the M5, it went down to 1:30. So a little bit of performance boost, and doing day-to-day video editing tasks and just running the software, I didn't really notice either computer feeling that much faster than the other. I'd say that's a pretty common theme with these machines, is when you're actually working on them, they don't necessarily feel like the M5 is all that much faster, but it's really just whenever the computer is actually processing things that's got those subtle improvements that do make it faster and that will save you time in the long run. The last test is the Lightroom Classic export test. I loaded about 500 raw files in and exported them all to JPEGs at 60% quality. On the M4, it actually took 2:56. On the M5, for whatever reason, it took 3:18. I ran the test over and over again. It always took longer on the M5, so I don't know if this is an Adobe optimization issue, but I do expect this to improve in the future. So after testing both of these extensively, they do perform pretty close in the real world, but I would say the M5 is definitely a nice incremental upgrade where people who do a lot with AI tasks are really going to notice the biggest benefits to them, especially if you want to run LLMs on the machine. But I would argue that's probably an area where you're not really buying a base model MacBook Pro for, because you really would benefit from more RAM as well as the Pro chip to get even faster memory bandwidth across the chip. So I wouldn't really recommend either of these for LLM use, but it is nice to note that Apple is working on that with the M5. And once we see the M5 Pro chip come out, that's when we should really see substantial increases in speed due to the higher base RAM as well as the higher memory bandwidth to allow the processor itself to access the RAM faster. So overall, the M4 and the M5 are definitely very close machines. I would say the real reason I would steer towards an M5 is not if you've got an M4 already, but if you've got an M3 computer or one of the older M2 or M1 MacBook Pros. The M5 is also going to be a better option than the M1 Max MacBook Pro at this time. It'll be close to the M2 Max for some tasks, but better than the M2 Max at some tasks as well. So overall, I think Apple did a great job with the M5. It just adding those subtle quality of life improvements, continuing to make things a little bit faster while still kind of sticking to that classic MacBook design. The biggest drawback is there's really no new flashy features with this. It looks just like any of the other MacBook Pros. There's no flashy new colors. The webcam's not necessarily improved, and it still tops out at Thunderbolt 4 speeds on the ports. My guess is it's going to take an M5 Pro or M5 Max if we want to see those Thunderbolt 5 speeds on this computer. But overall, I think the M5 is still a really great computer, but most of the changes are under the hood. If you're interested in buying one of these, I'll have links to buy in the description below. Make sure you check out B&H. They've often got some of the best sales on Mac computers. And also check out their PayBu card if you want a way to save a little bit of money as well. If you need more help buying a computer, leave a comment down below. Ask me any questions you've got about them. Also, I've got a link to my website where you can fill out a form and I'll get back to you and help you make your pick of your new MacBook. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content.